Former Minister of State for Education, Olorogun Kenneth Gbagi, has pledged to hand over the running of public schools to private investors if he's elected governor of Delta State in 2023. He assured that once elected governor, all public schools in Delta State will be handed over to private investors for effective and proper administration. He also added that existing schools in the state will be made viable, with each local government council getting 4 new secondary schools with boarding facilities. Can this work? Well, joining us to discuss further is Joe Edgar, co-founder and director at Hamilton and George Investment Bank. Joe, good morning to you. Thank you so much for joining us. What do you make of this proposal, I guess we can call it, from Kenneth Gbagi?
So, good morning. Thank you for having me. This has been a position someone was having canvassing for a while now. You get so government has shown a very, very large aptitude, you know, towards not being able to understand the issues in that sector, in the traditional sector. Because there's a capacity issue there. And because of the inefficiency inherent, you get, in bureaucracy, you get, we're not able to get the kinds of, what's the word to use now? The kinds of
efficiency?
Effect on education from government involvement. So this push towards having private sector involvement in it comes at the right time, comes highly recommended. You get, and then when I mean private sector involvement, I do not mean the outright capitalist, quick turnaround time, profit-making push. There has to be a middle leg now. A middle leg, that is those who push for social impact. You get, those who will not actually run for profit, you get, in their engagement in the educational sector. You get, those that will come in with patient capital, the kind of capital, you know, that will wait, you get, for fruition, you get, for us to be able to achieve the kind of impact that we're looking for in this space.
Okay, fantastic. Now, if public schools are run by private investors, doesn't that turn them into private institutions?
Obviously. Obviously. I think government should pull back at this point in time. I think government should pull back. Government should now go and build capacity, you get, in the area of regulation, you get, so that they're able to support this private initiative, social impact initiative, as they attempt, you get, to bring the much needed efficiency in that sector. Do you understand? So what you're talking about here now is just name calling, just labeling, you get, which is neither here nor there. Whether it's private sector, people who are running public schools, not my problem right now. My problem right now is how we can move most of the 18 million students outside of this educational system back into the educational system, and not just anyhow education, qualitative education. It's not about labeling right now, my brother. Okay. You get, it's about bringing efficiency back.
Okay, so doesn't that efficiency and the quality education you are calling for, doesn't it come at a cost? Some have said that if public schools are run by private investors, that will raise the cost of attending the schools.
That brings us back to what we were talking earlier on before coming on air. Do you get the need for patient capital? Do you get, so the turnaround time has to be such that, do you get, the investors would have that patience, do you get, to wait, do you get, for a long while. And that's where government comes in the area of capacity building in supporting this initiative. In the area of taxing, giving them tax holidays, in the areas of giving them import duty waivers for whatever they need to import and all of that. You see, I believe very strongly in the retail market. I believe very strongly in pushing retail initiatives in solving some of these problems. Now, if we have a school of investors, a cabal of investors, made up of thousands of people coming together in various SPVs, you get, to take on this educational, take on this sector, the cost will crash. The cost will crash. What we're having here now are a few investors who have shown interest in this sector, again, but who are under pressure to turn around their capital very quickly. And that's why I found out that the cost is way up there. Okay. Are you getting me now?
Yeah.
So if we have a wider base of investors who put in funds that they do not have to turn around very quickly, then that window will be open where there will be enough space, you get, to crash down the cost, to crash the cost. If you do the maths, you will see. Now, most of these very strong private schools with those school fees ranging to millions of naira, you get, they have very limited numbers of students in that school. Very limited numbers of students in those institutions. But if we have institutions with large student base, large capacity to handle this student base, this student population, the cost will crash.
Okay. Okay,
well, it can be done.
Fine, it can be done, but you're making a bet that there's enough of that large base to be able to fund. I mean, there's a lot of public schools out here. Isn't that, aren't you being a little bit optimistic in saying that there's good, that base
can
exist?
We can start somewhere. We do not have to begin and end in this generation. We can start somewhere. Do you understand? We can start somewhere. That investor base is there. Are you getting me? That investor base is there. What we're talking about here now is having, for example, let me just give a small example. Do you understand? Now, so we once tried to push an initiative that would take 500,000 Nigerians. Rotus, you know there are 500,000 Nigerians who can easily afford 100,000 naira as patient capital. So if you do the maths, 500,000 Nigerians put 100,000 naira in an SPV that will take on a school, we can replicate some of these private schools in all six geographical zones of this country.
Okay.
And that would make a very good start.
Yeah, so but fine, you can get those, but they can fund maybe how many schools? There are so many schools. I think is how do you scale that across the country?
Let's stop looking at, because this is what stops us from jumpstarting. Do you understand? Even if just one school can deliver at a cost that every Nigerian can afford, then it's an achievement. Mm. And then other people start to replicate it. So okay. If you begin to look at the challenges of this initiative, then we will get there.
Gotcha.
I think very clearly, let me send a very strong signal here now, government should scale back its involvement in education. Scale back very, very aggressively its involvement in education. I'd rather spend more time in building capacity in the area of regulation.
Okay, so what about other, in the West, United States, Europe, the public schools at the primary and secondary school level are publicly funded? Is that universities that you find more private funding? So
always try to compare. My brother, all these templates does not work.
Okay.
Do you understand? We have a unique problem here. Let's look for unique local solutions. We are trying to throw up unique local solutions into this problem. You are bringing this thing. Look, what has come out here now is that it's a three-pronged approach to this thing now. You get just a double approach we have been trying that has not been working, which is the government side of it and the few private individuals who are pushing schools that nobody can afford. So we're not asking for a third leg, impact investment in education. Investors who will come in and not necessarily looking for profit, but try to impact. That's the third leg they were trying to push. And that's the third leg government should encourage. That's the third leg this other private industry should encourage. It can be done, Rotus.
Okay.
It can be done.
And you think that there are enough investors that have the patience?
There are more than enough investors that have that patience.
And
there are more than
profit.
Enough investors that have that patience. Let me tell you something, Rotus. Let me tell you something.
Yes. Hmm?
I just told you now that I tried to push 500,000 Nigerians.
Yes.
Who will put 100,000 naira. Now, how many of our students are in the so-called privileged schools? Do the maths. Every parent in that school can put 100,000 naira down as equity investment in the so-called pseudo public school that would crash this cost of education and give our children quality education. Education is a bane, is a problem in this country. The moment we solve it, all our problems in this country will be literally over.
I like your optimism. Very quickly, we only got about a minute and a half to go. Speaking of funding, how would you solve the salary issues that ASU continuously faces year and year?
It's very clear. It's very clear. You're just talking about oil price dropping now. What does that? It impacts negatively on government revenues. Yeah, so government is facing myriad of challenges, security challenges, all sorts of challenges. Education just may not be their front burner. Meanwhile, education is the main thing. Government should scale back. Government can obviously not meet its obligations to ASU. Mm. Right from when I was in university, 10, 20 years ago, we have been fighting this ASU thing till tomorrow morning. So if we keep knocking our heads on the wall will not break. Our heads will continue to break. We have to look for a middle ground. Government should scale back.
I like
privatize universities, sell everything.
I like your optimism. Joe Edgar, co-founder, director at Hamilton and George Investment Bank. Thank you so much for talking about the education sector. Ambitious plans there.